correlations value two. That means I'm going to be focused now. Yes. The last times we discussed about the tri coefficients, then pi coefficient of correlations and biserial, point biserial. There you may, we need only the two variables only. If you have only two variables only, we can add up that kind of correlation. But when you go for the partial correlation or a multiple correlation, we need a three variables. We need a three variables. One variable is called x. So x is, we already know that x is called as an independent variable. Y is called dependent variable. Then one more variable, actually it is, the role is independent only, but it may be affect the both independent variable and dependent variable. So it's like we may call as a confounding variable. That variable name is called z. So I hope you understand now. For doing a partial correlation, we need a three variables. This is the basic conditions. For doing a partial correlation, we need a three variable. The first variable x, second variable is y, third variable is z. So the x is called as an independent variable. It is called causing variable. Independent variable is also called as a causing variable. Then the y is called as a dependent variable. This is called as an effect variable. This is called affecting variable. Otherwise, an output variable. Then we need a third variable. This variable only we can be control. We want to find out the exact relation between the x and y. After controlling the effect of the third variable effect, then is called as a partial correlation. So see, in this case, that's controlling for z is called as a confounding variable. This is called confounding variable. Some people, they are using the word x1 as a variable. Different names may be there. Now the term CC, partial. What's the partial? What is the partial? Just I'm going to ask you small questions to you. So now you are attending the online classes. In the online classes, if you want to get the exact quality of the online classes, lot of variables to be influencing. You are sitting for 1 hour for my classes. What are the factors may influencing to learn my idea, to learn my classes and all? One thing is internet speed. Other one is called your mobile supporting, then your mobile camera clarity, then next thing your mobile spaces, as well as that mobile charges. These are the basic factors it may affect to attend our classes. Then apparently in our husbands, they may give some work, or rather with the family members, they may ask in some other work during my classes. Therefore, it may lot of background variable or lot of variable may affect to attend my classes. I hope you understand. So it's not a single variable, it's not affecting. Lot of variable, it will be merged with each other and affect the classes and to attend now. So this kind of thing is called as a confounding variable. Normally, if you look on the any kind of study, some of the third variable may influence the independent variable as well as the dependent variable. Now, the partial correlation role is to be partial of the third variable effect and find out the exact relation between the independent variable to dependent variable. That is called partial correlation. This is the role is to take by the partial correlation. See, the partial correlation, the main role of the partial correlation is to measure of strength and directions. So now you know the strength. The strength is nothing but the scores of these courses may deviate from plus or minus only. So here the magnitude value, for example, 0.75 represents strength. 0.75 is strength of the correlations. The directions is nothing but whether the plus or minus. If you get the plus, it's called as a positive correlation. If you get the answer as a minus value, then we may tell us it's negative correlation. Therefore, the partial correlation is also measured. It is like a Pearson product moment correlation or other correlation only. But here it measuring the both strength as well as the directions. But the main conditions to it may check the only the linear relationship, if not the collinear, as well as the any other relationship, it won't be checked. And the main conditions to using the partial correlations, it's two continuous variable while controlling the effect of one or more continuous variables. So in this case, for example, I'm telling the minimum variables needed for doing a partial correlation is three. One is called x, independent variable, y is a dependent variable, z is a controlling variable or in a confounding variable. But in this case, all the three variables should be in a continuous nature, should be in a continuous state. This is the main conditions to use the cross-shape correlation. Now, the two continuous variables, these two continuous variables nothing but x and y. This continuous variable is x and y. X is independent, y is dependent. Whilst controlling the third, controlling the effect of one or more other continuous variable. Sometimes two or three continuous variable, it may act as a confounding variable too. That variable in ANOVA, we may call as an covariates. So that's why I'm highlighting the word covariates or the controlling variable. We may use the word controlling variable also. Now I'm moving to the next slide. Actually, the main purpose of doing a Gaussian correlation, this term is to be very clear, you may understand. The three things we are doing, but the three things same meaning only. One is called, we can take out or to eliminate or keep constant. So if you want to eliminate the third variable effect into the variable x and y, we can use the partial correlation. So I hope you understand. For example, x is an independent variable. X always affect. Therefore, I am telling as an independent variable x, independent variable. This is a causing variable. Therefore, f affects or effects is making effects on the y. So y is a output variable. This is called dependent variable. But some cases, just for example, I am telling x is a for example steady habits. So your steady habits is an x. Your dependent variable, your academic achievement. So for example, academic achievement of the students. There is a chance one more variable or other z. So that variable I may take it as a confounding variable or controlling variable. For example, I'm taking say intelligence. One variable. So in this case, all the three variables continuous nature. What will happen? The z may influence the study habits, and parallel that z may influence the academic achievement also, because based on the intelligence also academic achievement may change. But we want to check whether our independent variable, how much making the relationship between the, or making the association between the x and y. It's nothing but how the exactly the correlation happen or association happen between the study habits and academic achievement. That only we want to know. But inbuilt, some of the external extra variable, it may affect the two variables. Therefore, it may cause for the output too. Therefore, what we have to do, in statistically, we have to eliminate. So we have to eliminate the third variable effects. So I'm tracking. We have to eliminate the third variable effects with the use of Gaussian correlation. Then we can exactly find how much the X is contributing to Y after controlling the variable Z. This is called partial correlation. I hope you understand. We are partial outing the third variable effect into the independent variable and dependent variable. For the reason we are using a partial correlation. Yes, I am using the term, we can take out or eliminate or keep constant the effect of the third variable. That variable is called confounding variable, by using the statistical techniques called partial correlation. Even the partial correlation as well as the ANOVA, they're doing the same role only. But ANOVA is a regression variance based, but partial correlation is based on the association. That's only the difference. The effect of the contribution of the third factor is partial out. We have to eliminate. We may keep it as a third variable effect as a constant, or we have to eliminate or take out or to partial out the from the two variable x and y, from the correlation between the two factors. This technique is called as a partial correlation. I hope you understand the exact meaning of partial correlation. This example, this diagram also, it may giving the clear picture about the partial correlation. See here, in this case, the causing variable is called as an independent variable. Therefore, I put as an x as an independent variable. The effect variable is an independent variable, output variable. Therefore, x affects y, or affects y. But some of the other variables, some of the third variable or the fourth variable or fifth variables, any number of variables, okay, it may affect both the x and y. So what it happened, based on the x and y, based on the effect of the confounding variable, there is a chance the effect outcome may vary. So what we want to know, we want to check whether how much the x is contributing are affecting the Y. That's only we want to know. Otherwise, in what way the X having the association between Y after controlling the effect of the third variable. We want to eliminate the third variable effect. Otherwise, we can keep constant this variable. No, so I am making this box. This box we may take, this variable we may take as a constant or partial out, or can we eliminate the effect. Then finally, we need to check in how much the strength happened and relationship happened between the variable X and Y. For this, we can use the partial correlation. I hope you understand the exact meaning of partial correlation. Yeah. So some other people are giving the answer for my first question. Very good. Yes. Now I'm going to be highlight how many variables is made for doing partial correlation. At least we need one independent variable. So only one independent variable is needed for doing partial correlations. Because I'm selecting other color paper. Yeah. So one independent. So normally the independent we may call as a predictor variable too. That's why I'm putting as an independent variable. We need a predicted variable. So from the predictor we are finding the predictor. That is called dependent variable. That is called dependent variable, that also should be one. We have need a control variables. So it may be one or two or may. So that is called Z. This is called confounding variable. Normally in this case, the predictor one, it may one or more. So this is conditions, we can use the partial correlation. So I hope you understand. Independent variable one, dependent variable one. Then confounding variable one or more. This is a condition we can adopt a partial correlation. Yes, for example, I'm giving one example. I'm taking the anxiety as X. So anxiety means that is nothing but our independent variable. It is our causing variable. That's why I'm taking as a X. So X is affect Y. Normally X is affect Y. What is our Y? Our academic achievement. So based on the anxiety, academic achievement may change. If they have the low anxiety, academic achievement may be high. If they have the high anxiety, they have the less academic achievements. So this is an example I'm talking. So it may be a negative correlation because if a high anxiety, low academic achievement. If the low anxiety, high academic achievement. Therefore, I'm sure it's called as a negative correlation may happen between the two variables. But there is another variable also main things. For example, see here the variable name is called intelligence. Suppose if you are very intelligent, anxiety may vary. If you have the good intelligence also, there is a chance academic achievement also may influence. Therefore, there is a chance Z may influence both the two variables, both X and Y. But we want to check whether how much the relationship will happen between the anxiety and academic. That one we want to check after controlling the third variable. So we want to eliminate the third variable effect by use of this kind of partial correlation. So default or the inbuilt, this variable may affect these two variables. Therefore, what we have to do, we have to use this kind of third variable. We have to nullify this effect of third variable and check how much the X depends or X can contribute to the Y. I hope my voice is clear to all of you. Kindly give a response in the chat box. Your Saranya is putting his voice not here. Saranya, kindly check your net connection. Yeah, this is also one of the factors. See, in this case, it is the factor the Saranya is not getting the net. My voice is clear. So the quality of my lecture is based on my presentation is one. The next one is called her internet speed. Next, her power battery. Then their environment. So this much of variable is making influence. But I want to check the internet speed with my quality of my presentation. So for that, I want to check only the two variables. The one variable is called my effector. So my lecture. Otherwise, the output what she carrying from my lecture. That is a dependent variable. How much is getting the internet? That is called independent variable. So you want to check the internet speed of her as well as the learning happened to her. So if you compare with these two, lot of extraneous variable is there. But we want to, in the partial correlation, it may help us. It may give the exact picture or exact value about how the internet speed may contribute to the learning things after controlling the effect of the other variable like battery, then power supply, that family backgrounds. So these are things nullifying that finally find out how the internet speed may contribute or in what minute may associate the learning outcomes of her. So that is called as partial correlation. See, in this case, we may use the term R for the partial correlation, small r. But we may write the terms, R, then academic achievement. So see here, there is here things, academic achievement and anxiety. Why I put academic achievement and anxiety, then one dot, then intelligence. What is the logic? Anyone can tell? So here R, small r I'm using. The term we can use like X, Y. So X is an independent variable, Y is a dependent variable, then dot Z. Z here is act as a controlling variable or confounding variable. I hope you understand. So first we can take the X and Y, independent variable and dependent variable. After that one dot, then Z. Suppose I'm taking the other format, you can tell which is an independent variable, which is a dependent variable. And take X1 and Y. Then the next variable I'm taking as a X2 and X3. So in this case, how many independent variable, how many dependent variable, how many confounding variable? Please kindly give your answer in the chat box. I'm using the terms R, X1, Y, dot, X2, X3. Therefore, how many independent variable? In this case, only one independent variable, X1. Only one dependent variable, very good. So that is called Y. How many confounding variables are there? Very good. So the confounding variable, we have X2 and X3. So now you got it clear. So this is called a partial correlation. That's formula or the structure, how we can write the partial correlation results. We can write small r, it's a formula represents. Then in down, it's like a subscript. Okay, it's not a superscript, it's a subscript. We can write the X comma Y. X is an independent variable, Y is a dependent variable. Then after this, one dot, one small dot. Then after this, how many covariates are there or how many confounding variable? You have to be write it here. So in this case, I'm using only one, therefore I'm writing Z. So this is way we have to write the equation. This is the way we can represent the partial correlation. Therefore, here, what is the exam meaning? We are finding the value of, or we are finding the relationship between the X and Y after controlling the effect of the Z. This is meaning of this equation. Just I move to the next slide. Now, this slide, you may easily understand the exact meaning of the partial correlation. See here, the X is called anxiety in this case. So, in the previous example, we are using as anxiety. Y is called academic achievement. Z is called intelligence. See, this is called a Venn diagram. In this case, intelligence may having some intercept between the Y as well as there is the intercept between the X2. But the main task, the main role of the partial correlation, what is doing the sense? See here, this full is called intelligence. This full of is intelligence. I'm taking another color than it's easy for you. This full of is intelligence. This full of is intelligence. So what we have to do, we can take the all the Z as a constant value, or we have to eliminate the entire circle, the entire Z variable. Then we can check the relationship between the X and Y. Where is the X and Y happen? Only this area. Therefore, we are checking the X, Z, Y relationship. This part we are checking. So how much the relationship happened between the X and Y after controlling the effect of the third variable Z. So this is called as a partial correlation. I hope you understand. There's a three variables are there. The three variables intersect to each other, but we want to check how the X and Y, that's why I put the term R, X, Y, dot, Z, variance shared by the academic achievement and anxiety, not influenced by the intelligence or control. After controlling the variable Z, we can check the exact relation between the X and Y. So this is a place. So this is a place is called the relationship between the X and Y after controlling the effect of the Z. But normally, see here, that intelligence may influence both this side as well as here also is influencing, here also influencing. we want to eliminate the Z, the third variable effect. Then finally, we have to check in what way only the X and Y having the association or relationship between the two variables. So for that purpose, we are using the partial correlations. Just I'm going to throw one more examples also to you. See here, in this example, height is a independent variable, then weight is a dependent variable. So if you want to check the correlation, we are getting this value only. So how much the close bond between, this is normally we are using the term R square value. So how many percentage these those are the X and Y to be associated to each other. So this is the place, is the association place. But in the case of only two variables. But if you come with the third variable, see here, this is X, this is Y. In the third, Z is a variable. So what will happen? Normally the X and Y, if you found, we may get the entire portions only. But the third variable effect also we have to nullify. Therefore, the third variable effect, where it's happened, so this is a place, see here, the entire Z we have to eliminate. But if you eliminate the entire effect, only the X and Y, for example, here I put the effect 0.8. So there is a chance 0.8, the relation between the X and Y. But after controlling, I'm eliminating this part also. I'm eliminating this part of the relationship there. Then after that, I'm checking only this area. I'm selecting the other color. Then it's easy for you to understand it. So I'm selecting the other color. Yeah. So the yellow mark, see here, the yellow mark area. I'm going to find out the only the yellow mark relationship between the X and Y after controlling the variable of Z. So it may become 0.68. So what it means, previously we are getting this score as 0.8, but now we are getting this is 0.68. It means that after controlling the Z, there is a chance our X and Y relationship will be 0.68. So it means there is a influence happened from the Z, because the reason only the previous is 0.8 comes. Once you control the third variable effect, we are getting the exact value or exact relation between the X and Y, that is none other than 0.68. For that purpose only we are using the partial correlation. I hope you understand the meaning of partial correlations. Partial correlation, the role, what is the role in the sense? It may reduce or it may nullify or it may partial out the third variable effect into the variable X and Y. So we can check the exact relation between the variable of independent variable to the dependent variable after controlling the effect of the third variables, this kind of variable. See, in this case, just they are taking the two variables. In this case, they are taking, say, IQ is an independent variable. In this example, IQ is an independent variable. Then grade is a dependent variable. Then motivation is a covariance. So in this case, see here, they want to check only this area only. So only this part, how much the X and Y having the influence, having the association between two. But default, see here, there is a small error also which may comes here. This part also may comes to independent. But if you're using the partial correlation, it may reduce the, it may keep the constant of the entire B value. Entire B value is taken as a constant. Finally, you can check only this part only. Only this part relationship between the X and Y. Then this value is exactly correct how much the X associated with the B, Y, or how much the X, the variance are making the contributions of Y. That we can found it from this kind of correlations only. Now I move to the next. This is also another path diagram base. See here, there is an X2, X3, and here this is an independent variable. X1 is independent, X2 is independent, then X3 is a confounding. See here, in this case, after influencing the X3 to all the variable, the R12, R23, see here, there is a scores, which means that the 1 and 2 relationship is 0.29, the third and second variable 0.62. If you keep the third variable effect, this intervening effect, I keep as a zero. I'm nullifying the effect. Then after that, if you check the relationship between the two variables of P12 and 23, see here, previously 0.29, now it's 0.23 after controlling the third variable effect. It means that most of the time, the third variable may make influence to the variable X and Y. Similarly, in this case, Here the after controlling the third variable 0.6 only, but in the case of the second and third variable it's called 0.62. Therefore there is a 2% 0.02% it may influence 2% may influence because of the third variable. In this kind of partial correlation it may nullify that effect. So we can exactly check how the independent variable can associate with the dependent variable with the use of partial correlation. For that purpose only we are using a partial correlation. I hope you understand. For doing any correlation, we must know in what purpose we are using that. Now, in the partial correlation, there is a first order, second order, or higher order is there. Suppose if you have only one covariate, see here in this case only one covariate, but in this case the two covariates are there, 3 and 4. If you are using one covariate, it's called as a first order correlation, partial correlation. If you're using the two covariate, it's called a second order. If you are using three covariates called as a the confounding variable is called as a third order. But generally if you go with more than one it's called as higher order partial correlation. Generally we are using more than one covariate or more than one confounding variable, we use the term high order partial correlations. But I'm going to focus on only this one only. R1213. So in the R1123 the formula see here. So one independent variable, two is a dependent variable. If you write as say based on the x and y, R x comma y, x is independent variable and y is a dependent variable and z is a confounding variable. So normally we are going to find out the x y relationship only. So we are going to check the exact relation between the x and y after controlling. Therefore I am using the terms minus. See here, we want to check the variance of x and y after controlling the variable of z influence, the third variable influence. The third variable where they influence x to z influence is there, y to z is there. Therefore I have to be minus it, or I have to be nullify, I have to partial out with this use of minus symbol. So I am using with 1 3, the first variable or x with y or x with z, sorry, x with z, then correlation y with z. So now we got clear. So we must know the effect of the 1 and 2 only. For that we have to nullify the effect of the 1 3 with 2 3 and 2 3, then divided by root of the square 1 minus the second part of this one, r square 1 3 into root of 1 minus r square 2 3. It's very easy to memory also. Just I am writing for the easy purpose. Just I am having only two variables, just r comma y dot z. How we can write it? See here, we want to check the exact relation between the x and y after controlling. Therefore I am using the term minus of the third variable influence. Third variable where the influence, third variable influence x once, then third variable influence y also, therefore y z, divided by, I am using the term 1 minus, so 1 minus of this first term square, r square of xy or xz, then root of the second term 1 minus r square yz. So this is a formula of the partial correlation. If you go with two covariate, the formula may change. R12.3, R14.3, R24.3, then root of this part r square 14, then r square 243. Then for if you want to check the R12.3, we can apply this formula. I hope you understand. For R123 is nothing but this formula. So if you go with the two order or the higher order, we can start with the first order, then after finishing the first order only we can go with higher order, because it will be continuous with each other. Now I am moving to the computation part. Before that, just I am telling once again, we are denoting the symbol of partial correlation or x comma x dot xy dot z. It means that the correlation coefficient x and y controlling for z, the third variable is z. The formula we already discussed here, which I am moving to the next one. In what are the condition we can use the or the assumption we can use the partial correlation? This question may comes for the exam also, because yes, this also assumptions is needed for doing a partial correlation. So we need one dependent variable, so only one dependent variable and one independent. See here, I already mentioned one independent and one dependent variable. it may be a continuous scale. So continuous means it may be an interval or ratio. So that things you understand, interval or ratio. It won't be a categorical variable like nominal or ordinal. It should be an interval or ratio. That's the first assumption. The second assumption, one or more control variable. See, this is called as a confounding variable. It's also a continuous scale. So all the three variable are, all the variables should be in a continuous nature. Then only we can use the partial correlation. This is the main thing. The next thing, the relationship between the each two, for example, x to y or y to z or x to z, everything should be a linear, should be a linear relationship, not in a correlation relationship. That also we can check. Then no significant outliers. It means that some other times that some scores may be light near, somewhat so away from the other scores. For example, in your classroom, I am conducting one examination. All the students are getting nearly 60 around only. Only one or two students, they're getting below 10. So what is happened? That two students may mark influence the entire group students. Therefore, we have to check this kind of distributions are there, whether the only two students are, few of them sitting in different places, others are sitting around. We have to nullify, we have to check whether how many outliers are there, how many data are spreaded not around the data. That we have to check. Then finally, variables should be approximately normally distributed. These are the five assumptions we can go with. This kind of partial correlations. Now I move to the next one. Partial correlation is an example. Just I'm going to highlight now as one computation part also. See here, there is a three variables they given: husband, housework, then number of children. So based on the number of children, if the home having more number of students, normally children, normally the role, the housework time may be increased. So therefore, X is a number of children, Y is a husband homework, housework. So how much the husband is spending the homework, housework. Then husband, years of education. Suppose he is good and qualified, he won't be spend the time in the home. He may work in somewhere, only the other member can be help them to be lead the family. So here, there's a three variables are there. Now you have to tell which is a independent variable, which is a dependent variable in this case. So only the two variable I'm highlighting. The variable name, one is called husband, housework. Second one is called number of children. So please, I request the students, kindly type the short word, which is an independent variable in this case, which is a dependent variable. It's an independent variable, only two variables, number of children as well as the husband's homework. So in this case, which is an independent variable? Normally, we are using the term independent variable as a IV, dependent variable as a DV, as a symbol, otherwise X and Y. I request, I hope you understand my questions now. In the two variable of husband or housework as well as the number of children, which variable may act as the independent variable? Very good. So Surya is correct, exactly. Husband, housework. So it means that the children's are numbers high, damn sure the husband's time spending with the home, doing the home home activities much. So therefore, independent variable is the number of children and dependent variable is the husband, housework. But there's a third variable that is called husband's years of education. That also may influence in the husband's housework time. So suppose if he's good qualification, he's an IAS officer, IPS officer, he won't spend time with their homes, no? So that's also may influence him. And this education also may influence the number of children, because those who are well educated, they won't be, they won't give birth for the more children also. Therefore, the Z may influence both X and Y. Now, what we have to do, we have to partial of the third variable effect. We have to partial of the third variable effect. We can check how in what way X and Y is associated with each other after controlling the third variable. So see here, that's why they're given the questions. There is a told sample. The sample name is A, B, C, D after here. Now, in this case, they're given the data like this. This is the data they may be given. Now, there is a relation between the X, Y, comma Y. What is Y, comma Y? So husband, home, housework, and husband, housework, same variable. Therefore, the variables, same variable, therefore it comes one. Because the SPS output, it may comes like this only. Because it may compare with Y to Y2. So Y is nothing but dependent to dependent. Therefore, it's one. But if you see the X, number of children, number of children with husband housework 0.50. It's nothing but R of X comma Y. So R of X comma Y or Y comma Z. We can use the term Y comma X also. YX. Now this is husband housework. It may influence to the husband years of education. That is called negative. So what it happened? If husband's years of experience, education is high, household time is less. So it's called negative. See here the terms negative. What it means? If husband years of education is high, household time is less. If years of education is less, the household time is to be high. So therefore, it's called as a negative correlation. See the case of number of children and husband housework, a positive correlation. But husband years of education with husband housework is a negative correlation. Now you are easily understand. The same thing it happened. So x to x is the same one value. But number of children with z variable, so the third variable, and the number of children in what way we contribute or the relationship between the husband's years of education. That is called minus 0.47. It means that if the husband's years of education is too high, number of children are low. If the husband years of education is less, number of children are high. Therefore, it comes negative. So very good results. Now the z is what? So now what our role? We have to check the exact relationship between x and y after controlling the variable of z. It's not controlled, but default it may influence, that is output it comes here. Now the role for us, we want to check what is the exact relation between the x and y after controlling the variable of z. We know the formula r of yx. We can use the term x comma y or yx, because R x comma y, just I'm writing, R x y is equal to R y x. So because the relationship between the x and y is equal to relationship between the y x. So both is same ones. Okay. So in this case, I'm taking the R y x. This is an R y x. This is R y z. This value is R y z. This is value is R x z. Okay, so we need the three variable only, three scores only. Therefore, we get the scores from here. We can easily substitute. Now, r y x value is nothing but 0.50. So I am writing here r y x is equal to minus 0.30. r x y minus 0.47. I substitute the value and root of 1 minus r y x whole square, then root of 1 minus r x z square, then if you simplify this one, it comes 0.50 minus 0.14, the root of 1 minus 0.9 into 1 minus 0.22. then after simplifying these things, you may get this like this 0.36. this is a denominator numerator simplifications. Then in down, root of 0.91 into root of 0.78. If you simplify it more, you may get this one. Then finally, you may get the numerator value 0.36, denominator value 0.84. Then finally, we are getting the score 0.43. So now we are getting, it means that the relation between the x and y after controlling the variable of z. But see here, what is our value here? What is the previous value x and y, or y is that 0.50, but after nullifying the effect, your value is somewhat less, but both is positive only. This also positive, this also positive, but previously some chance there is here influence may happen because of the z. Therefore the score is come 0.50, but now we are eliminating the third variable effects. Now, after eliminating third variable effect, we are checking with the exact association between x and y. We are getting the score 0.43. This is called partial out. We are partializing the third variable or z variable. Finally, we are checking, or finally we are getting how much the strength and association happened between the two variables of x and y. For the purpose only, we are using a partial correlations. Now, see here, the partial correlation value is. Previously the Pearson product moment correlation value is 0.50, but after doing a partial correlation, our score is come 0.43. this is a relationship between x and y only. This is a relationship between x and y, but this is a relationship between x and y after controlling the z. But here we are not controlling. That's why there is a score is 0.50, but after controlling it comes 0.43. Therefore, it is an exact score. It is an exact relation between the two variables. But both is a positive only. Therefore, we are telling it's a direct relation between the both. So now I'm adding one more feather of this also. Now we are talking about the partial correlation. So I hope you understand how to do a partial correlation. But the exam point of it, a partial correlation computation is not needed. They may ask only the theoretical things only. Then you can use the partial correlation. So when we can, in the sense, if we have the third variable, that is called confounding variable, if you want to control this confounding variable effect into the variable, independent variable into the dependent variable, we can use the partial correlation. Now I'm going to add one more things also. There is a difference between the partial correlation and semi-partial correlation. So what is the difference between the partial and semi-partial? So the questions may come. See here, just I'm going to partial correlation, this example, then you may get it. In this, just I'm clearing this one, then you may understand. Yeah, see here, in this diagram, the partial correlation, we are eliminating the entire, we are eliminating the entire z. So this is called partial correlation. So it means that the influence between the variable x and y are high to h parallelly, this area also we remove. So we are removing the entire area and we are checking the partial correlation. But semi-partial means it may keep one area. For example, it may keep this area, you can eliminate only this part only. So that is called semi-partial. Instead of eliminating the entire things, only one part. Yeah, eliminate, exactly, Prasanna is correct. We can eliminate only one portion or one variable's influence only we have to eliminate. That is called semi-partial. That things I will explain with the diagram, then we may easily get it. See here, this diagram it shows. This is called semi-partial. There is an independent variable, dependent variable. Then this is called independent variable, dependent variable. This is independent variable 2. It's nothing but our third variable. That's why they use the word independent variable. Confounding variable. So normally, the semi-partial, this part is one semi, A is one semi, and C is the other semi part. In the partial correlation, we can eliminate both A and B. We can eliminate both A and C. We can eliminate both A and C. But in the semi-partial, we can eliminate only one only. We can eliminate A after we can check with the C also. So we cannot, we are not eliminating the third way, the C part influence. Without eliminating the C area elimination, we are checking the relationship between the X and Y. That is called as a semi-partial. But in the partial correlation, we have to remove the two variable effects, A and the two part effect also we have to remove. Exactly the Prasanna said is correct. We eliminate only one variable, one part of variable influence we have to eliminate. So in this case, you may easily understand this one. Semi-partial, here, if you eliminate only the A part, that also semi-partial. Otherwise, if you eliminate the only the C part, then it's also a semi-partial. Then this is another example. See here, they want to check the relationship between the AB. So this is the independent variable and B is a dependent variable. B is a dependent variable, A is an independent variable. In this case, we want to eliminate the third variable effect of C. But only this portion are eliminating. Only this portion are eliminating. But this portion is to be there. So here we are controlling the only this part and checking the partial correlation. Then it's called a semi-partial. Now I hope you understand the difference between the partial and semi-partial too. This is a homework. If you time possible, you can do it. I will share this PPT also later. If you time possible, you can check the two variable relationship between the x and y, R1 and 2, after controlling the variable, the third. That's why I'm giving the data. R12 is 0.6, R13 is 0.5, R23 is 0.3. So if you time possible, you can do it and check it in what manner the partial correlation there is to be before compared to the Pearson product correlation. So thank you all. I hope you understand how to do a partial correlation, then you can do a partial correlation, as well as the you may aware of it, what are the assumptions we can adopt a partial correlation. So thank you. Bye.